So in this colony, I've been trying to get the bees to switch. I'm trying to get them to build in medium supers because I'm going to switch to all mediums. And I couldn't get them to build comb on the medium, so I put mediums in the deeps. And this is what I get out of it. I get a little bit of comb on the bottom, but they are building in the on the frames eventually. So that's good. I'm just going to cut that stuff off and put it in an empty frame. And it's working on that frame, but on this frame, they built comb underneath, and they're just starting to build comb on the actual plastic. So I think if I had, I think the problem is that there's not a lot of wax coating on this foundation that I happen to have, and they're just not interested in it. So here just shows you that they build comb on a foundationless piece of the frame, which is underneath the frame, quicker than they do on the actual comb on the plastic foundation. So it's a good sample of that. I've never seen bees ignore foundation like this before, but this is the foundation that I got this year. And I get the feeling it's either the plastic, there's just not enough wax on the coating of plastic for the bees to be interested in it. But the bees really what I should do is, if I want them to build, then maybe I'm gonna do this, that's a good idea. If I want them to build comb, I'm just gonna have to pull out that foundation completely and let them, and just feed them like crazy and get them to build foundationless comb, because they're not touching this. They've definitely shown a preference to building foundationless over this foundation. I've never had this happen before where they just completely ignore, not completely, but they're not showing enough interest in building on this plastic foundation. Yeah, this is a sample of what's going on here with this crappy comb, this crappy foundation. The bees are not touching it. This is next to a frame of brood that I found, and they're not touching it. This is useless. So I'm going to actually pull these frames and put in foundationless frame, and hopefully they'll build some comb on the foundationless and do something, because this is terrible. Here's a frame that has just a bit of starter strip on it, put in about a week ago, I think, and they've completely filled in that frame with comb. And there's even some brood on it too, which is beautiful. Exactly what I wanted from this colony, from these mediums this year. We're trying to convert them to brood nests. And there's a sample of what I got out of this useless foundation. So if you buy foundation, note to myself, make sure that it's loaded with wax, because if it doesn't have wax on it, and this is mostly just plastic, the bees are just not touching it. They will build, either ignore it, or they will build useless hunks of junk, like little globs of honey on it like that, but nothing else. It's just stupid. Just a waste of time. Like, don't even sell this stuff. So that's a good sign. Foundationless, working like gangbusters. So, and there's another frame right there that's foundationless, that's full of comb. So that's it. I'm going to go get some foundationless right now, plonk it in this thing, and hope for the best, put a feeder on them, and go to town. Okay, well, now you're listening to some bonus material. Everybody else is tuned out. They saw the mudsongs.org thing pop up on the screen, and they all just shut her down and went to bed. But not you. You're smart. Good for you. Here's the little extra bit of information if you're still listening. I heard from other beekeepers on the island of Newfoundland, where I keep my bees, that their bees too were having trouble drawing out comb this past summer, the summer of 2019. And there may have been something in the wind that caused that to happen. It may have been the cold spring we had. I don't know. But there were other beekeepers on the island who keep bees in better conditions than I do, because I keep bees right next to the freezing ocean. And even their bees were not drawing out comb. So there might have been something on the go this summer that was causing the bees to not draw out comb as profusely as they normally would. I don't know. The other solution to this bees not building comb situation is to paint
beeswax on the plastic foundation. And I don't think I mentioned that in the video, but I probably should have. And basically what people do is they take clean beeswax from their own hives, preferably. They melt it down and they paint the plastic foundation with wax. And you put an extra thick layer of wax on both sides of the plastic foundation. And that encourages the bees to build comb. And apparently it works very well. I've never had to do that, but I'm probably going to do it now. And I'm probably going to do what I can to preserve all my wax, because I used to just give my wax away. But now I'm probably going to start doing that. So that's something to do. Paint those plastic foundation with beeswax, and it probably solves the problem. And the other thing is, of course, like I did in the video, remove the plastic foundation. Just put in some foundationless frames between frames of drawn comb, and the bees, in my experience, they will draw it out. So my only problem with that is in the past, I've gotten more drones from using all foundationless frames, and more drones and less honey. And I didn't enjoy that, so that's why I went back to plastic. But apparently it evens itself out. It will work itself out if you go all foundationless, and you'll get lots of drones at first, but eventually the bees redraw the wax or something, and you end up getting a normal ratio of drone brood to worker brood, and you get a good honey harvest and all that jazz. So those are three things that I thought I'd mention. For those who are brave enough, smart enough to sit around and look at a blank screen while I'm talking into this microphone and giving some extra information. So that's it, my big thoughts for today. See you later.